So next will be the information communication technology and the robotics. This is the second part. The first part we had spoken about the space technology, defense technology, electronic and green technology. Second part we are speaking with the IT. So IT, as per the previous thing what I had said, please be very clear that information technology is once a second of a topic which is highly connected to your daily life. Please pay attention in such a way, highly connected to your daily life. Observation matters a lot for this topic rather than reading plenty of informations. Observe a lot of things. What happens in and around you, that matters a lot for this kind of a topic. Okay. Let me decode. Individual area, what are the things that you need to cover under the IT topics? So first comes the computings. Computing types. So here, try to focus with respect to the quantum computing, supercomputing, cloud computing, grid computing, nano computing, edge computing, fog computing, optical computing, green computing, mobile computing. These are the different types of computing which we need to focus. Almost some 10 different types of computing asset. Now, under the computing topic, read the computing topic in such a way with respect to their futures. So future in sense, quantum computing and all task specific. They can do the only one task at a time. They are not eligible to do the multitasking. Quantum computing, supercomputing were task specific nature. That's one among the future. If you come across a word called as a quantum computing, we have a word called as quantum supremacy. Recently, this Google company had done a project Sycamore. Under that, they had achieved the quantum supremacy concept. You need to know about what is quantum supremacy, what is quantum entanglement. Like that, have an analysis with respect to the future. If you are coming at the future in sense, your answer for the future need to be completed within a single line. It should not exceed more than a single line. Like that, you need to arrive to a conclusion in a nutshell word. So your nutshell definition need to be there for each and every kind of a future. So questions can be done with respect to computing in such a way. First, you need to go with respect to the futures behind the computings. Second, you need to go with respect to the applications. Third, focus with respect to the examples, recent example. If you come across a word called as a summit, even today also we had reported a news with respect to summit, once a second of a fastest supercomputer in the world, world's fastest supercomputer summit. They are using the summit supercomputer to identify the drug which can be an effectively fight against this coronal outbreak disease. So they are testing which drug can be effective with the help of the summit supercomputer. So like that, each and every supercomputer will have their own application. So try to go with respect to an application. And third one, have some examples behind each and every supercomputers. For an Indian level, fastest supercomputer in India in the current date remain to be the Pratyush. Know with respect to the examples. So these three things, if you are going to cover it for all the different types of computing, that's more than enough. And finally, if you want to complete it, suppose you don't have an example in sense, go with respect to project names. In order to promote the cloud computing, what project government of India had initiated? What is DigiLocker? Whether DigiLocker comes under this cloud computing or not? What is project Mehraj? Like that, try to have a glance. Okay. So if you're covering that, types of computing will be getting over. Second type of a topic is types of malwares. Types of malwares. So here try to focus with respect to the hackers. First focus with respect to the hackers. Next with respect to the names of malwares. Names of the malwares. When I come for names of the malwares, please kickstart your preparation with the virus. Next, worms, Trojan, ransomware, Viper, V-I-P-E-R, Viper, scareware, adware, spyware. Under the spyware, try to complete espionage, sabotage, DOS, DDoS, DOS, DDoS, juice jacking. Once a second of word, what we are seeing in the recent time, juice jacking, crypto jacking, QRL jacking, QRL jacking, web crawlers, So these are the names of the malware, what we came across in the recent time. In case of a malware topic, how you need to read the topic in sense? First, get with respect to the features of the malware. So first, get with respect to the mode of infection. That will be the first line of addressing. Mode of infection. Some requests online mode, some requests offline mode, some requests both the things. So first, go through the topic with respect to the mode of infection. Second line of scenario you need to touch with respect to what happens to the infected system after the attack. Some will corrupt all your files and folders. Some will make your system to perform in a poorest manner. Some will be able to lock all your files and folders in the local drives. So each and every malware will have their own specification in order to trouble your infected system. That's in the second line of focusing. So first line, mode of infection happens. Second line, what happens further due to infection? And third line, go with respect to the remedial measures. So remedial measures in sense, some request antivirus software, some request with respect to the sandboxing technique, which is record sandboxing technique. Trojan, of course, requests a sandboxing technique. So like that, regarding to the remedial measures, that should be the third line. And finally, complete a topic with respect to recent examples, what we came across the malwares. More than enough. Types of malwares. Third comes with respect to the data transferring technology. Data transferring technology. Start with respect to IRDA. Infrared data transfer. Next, Bluetooth. Wi-Fi. WiMAX. RFID. NFC. Near field communication. Li-Fi, Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi Direct, Wi-Fi Direct, In-Flight Connectivity. So these are the data transferring technology which we need to focus. Now, in this data transferring technology, what are the point of scenario I need to focus on? First point of scenario, you need to focus with the regions of spectrum which is used by the technology. Some technology requests radio wave, some requests IR wave, some requests with respect to visible light region. You need to focus with respect to region which is used for the spectrum for the technology. Second point of focus, whether it's one-to-one connection or a two-way connection. So some requests point-to-point, some will be the point-to-multipoint. That will be the second point of focusing. And third will be the whether transmission and receiving takes place simultaneously or only it can support for a transmission and receiving alone, which means dual mode or one mode of transmission takes place. Fourth. The fourth comes in such a way regarding to the authentication. So regarding to the authentication, how far it is secured or insecure. One example I can able to say that in case of a Bluetooth and all, mode of data transferring is secure or highly non-secure in sense. Mode of transferring is highly secure because in case of a Bluetooth, dual verification is required in both the ends. Sender need to verify the device, who is going to be the receiver. Receiver need to verify who is going to be the sending device. Since verification is required in both the ends, dual verification is there. Of course, the Bluetooth mode of data transferring is highly secure. So that should be the next point of focusing in this topic. After completing with the mode of security, finally complete the topic with respect to recent examples. For example, Wi-Fi Direct, share it application, which we widely use with respect to smartphones, works with based upon the Wi-Fi Direct. Next example, go with respect to the FASTag stickers, which we are mounted with the vehicles for the crossing the e-toll plazas, works based upon the RFID. Metro station cards, it works based upon the NFC. Like that, try to complete the topic with some well-known examples, which you quite common have in the market. That's it. If you're completing it, then the topic will be getting over. On one nation, one card, it uses the NFC as well as the chip-based technology is there. If you're going with respect to the Indian Post Office payment card, there it uses the QR codes alone. It doesn't have the magnetic strip, black color magnetic strip. It doesn't have the IC chip. It has only the QR code, the technology which is used with the QR codes. So like that, complete the topic with respect to the examples whichever you tend to have in the market. Next. Fourth one. Different types of digital payment system. So in this case, start your topic with the net banking. After net banking, Aadhaar card enabled payment service. Next, BIM, UPI, QR codes, mobile wallets, plastic money. It refers for the credit card and the debit cards. So these are the things that you need to cover under the different types of digital payment system. In case of the digital payment system, what are the point of focus you need to have in sense? First, get an idea in such a way. What is the basic technology you tend to have? What one thing I can commonly say in sense, what are the digital type of payment you tend to have in the market? Either it's net banking or QR code scanner, API. API technology is common. API technology is common. Apart from API technology, each and every different types of payment will have their own technology. That will be a secondary line of scenario. So first focus with respect to what kind of a technology is there behind the digital payment. Second, after that, try to focus with respect to levels of authentication. That comes a major important area to have a question. You need to know about how many levels of authentication there for the BIM, how many levels there for the UPI, how many levels there for the QR code. Know with respect to levels of authentication. And third, go with respect to some types and examples. In case of QR code and all, we have the static QR code as well as dynamic QR code. In case of a government-owned Bharat QR code, we have a static Bharat QR code as well as dynamic Bharat QR code. So you need to know a glance with respect to types as well as with respect to some examples. So complete the topic in such a way so that you'll be getting satisfied with respect to different types of digital payments. Next, the fifth one, complete the topic with respect to the mobile generation networks. Mobile generation network. So when it comes for mobile generation network, currently in India, we tend to stand in the 4G world. So next generation is going to be the 5G. So we better start your preparation from the 0G. Zero generation, 1G, 2G, under 2G we have 2.5, 2.75, next 3G, 3.5, 3.75, 3.9, that is otherwise called as LTE, under 4G. Under the 4G, we have 4.5G, that is a volt. Finally, complete your topic with 5G. That's it. Different types of mobile generation network. In case of mobile generation network, what need to be focused? Okay. First comes, go with respect to one technical concept. What kind of a switching it uses? Circuit switching or packet switching? That will be a technicality, but no other option to be left to. Try to know it as a kind of a factual information. Second, data transfer rate. You not to worry about the numerical. Try to get an idea whether data transmission takes place in KBBS or MBBS or GBBS. That much amount of information is more than sufficient. You need to know about either the data transmission takes place in KBBS or MBBS or GBBS. You need not to worry about the numerical values. Third comes with respect to the other names which we tend to give for the generations. For example, 2.5 is otherwise called as an edge. 2.5 is called as a GPRS. 2.75 is called as an edge. So 75 is edge, 2.5 is a GPRS. So that you need to know about the other generation, other names for the generations. Apart from the other generation, you need to know about the meaning behind each and every alphabet letter which you tend to come across above the signal strength. If you come across HSPA, 3.5. H plus incense, 3.75. Advanced HS plus, improved HSPA, that is called as an H plus. So like that, behind each and every alphabet, we have certain kind of information to be present. So try to know that information. So once you've done it, then the topic which is required for the mobile generation network will be getting over. That's it. So these are the areas which we need to focus with respect to the information, communication, technology. Further, we have certain other topics also. So still the robotics topic you need to touch and other things need to be there. So next, we need to move with respect to big data, IoT, artificial intelligence, next, blockchain technology, for these topics, what I can recommend is, focus more with the applications, focus more with the application that is required for covering this topic. Apart from the application, if they are going to frame the sentence, then sentence will be coming with respect to the futures. Even in 2018, we got a question about the IoT. In order to make the statement is right for an IoT, you need to read the whole paragraph. It was nearly about some 10 to 15 lines. A whole paragraph was given, a large paragraph was given. As a matter of reading it, you can able to come to a conclusion. The paragraph speaks for the IoT. So, answer is going to be simple. Question will be there from the applications only. So, first focus with an application, then focus with respect to the futures. That's more than enough for this kind of a topic. Because all the topic what I had mentioned over here is a kind of a mains related topic. Even though it's a mains related topic, still scope is there for the prelims in the aspect of an applications. That we can't able to neglect it. And in case of an artificial intelligence, try to read the topic with respect to types of artificial intelligence. Applications and recent examples like the Vayu Mitra, what the ISRO had unveiled, as well as Sophia, it's a kind of a self-awareness robot that we have in the world's first robotic citizen. You need to go with respect to the recent examples what we came across the artificial intelligence. Blockchain technology, the same such a kind of a future. Go with respect to the futures first, applications, and some current news regarding to the Libra cryptocurrency, because cryptocurrency is one such a kind of an area which functions based upon the blockchain. But make it very clear that blockchain is not used only for the cryptocurrency trading. Apart from the cryptocurrencies, it is used for several sectors. Make this point is very clear that mainly it was previously preferred for the cryptocurrency trading, but now it is used for several sectors. But anyhow, we have a current affairs news in the name called as Libra, it's a kind of a cryptocurrency of the Facebook company. And next, the seventh one, this topic will be a kind of a pure technicality topic, net neutrality versus free basics. Pure technical topic. So in this case, try to know about what is net neutrality, what is the free basics, what are the recent recommendations given by the TRAI, Telecommunication Regulatory Authority of India, what recommendations they are given, what are the seven recommendations, almost they are given some seven recommendations, go through the seven recommendations. That's enough for this topic. So this seventh topic alone will be a slightly technicality. And technicality in sense, conceptual wise technicality, they won't frame any kind of a technical words. Conceptual understanding need to be there to solve some questions. Okay. Finally, as usual, go with respect to some miscellaneous current affairs. Let me give you a few current affairs. One such a kind of a thing is called as voice over Wi-Fi. Interconnection utility charge, IUC charge, interoperable Wi-Fi, SIM swapping, eSIM versus virtual SIM. Next, Project Shakti. Under a difference, we have spoken about Mission Shakti. This is Project Shakti, project of IIT Madras to develop India's first indigenous microprocessor. In the name called as Rice Creek, Project Shakti. Project Parashakti. Agumbe. Last year, we got a question in the name called as Digital Signature. Parallel try to complete with respect to electronic signature, electronic signatures, facial recognition. Right. So these are like this. You try to DTH. So DTH, types of DTH, application of DTH. So like this, if you are completing that, miscellaneous current affairs part will be getting over. Okay. Next. So go with the question analysis. So this is a question. What we got in 2019, LTE with the volt. So now, if you are learning under the mobile generation topic, definitely you will be coming across LTE is commonly marked as 3G and volt is commonly marked as an advanced 3G. It's a 4G. So first is wrong. LTE is data only technology and volt is a, LTE is data only. That's right. Volt is a voice only technology. No, volt is a kind of a voice as well as a data technology. So both the statement is wrong. Which is right? They are asking that neither one, not two. Both the statement is wrong. See, conceptual based question. If you're knowing, even though it's a conceptual based question, it's a simple concept. If you're knowing with respect to simple concept, then easily, hardly you're spending about some less than a minute to say the statement is right or wrong. That's it. Next. Second comes in the name called as a Li-Fi. So Li-Fi, with reference to the Li-Fi, recently seen in the news, which among the following statement is right? So this is a previous year UPSC question only. So Li-Fi, in sense, instead of a radio waves, for the Wi-Fi we are using the radio waves, but in case of a Li-Fi, instead of a radio waves, we tend to prefer with respect to the visible light region. They are saying that it uses light as a medium. Yes, if you are using the light, of course, what happened? High speed data transmission will be there. Set point one is right. Set point two, it's a wireless technology. Of course, it's a wireless only. Wireless technology, it is a several times much faster than the Wi-Fi. When you are preferring the visible light region for an operation, light travels much faster when compared to the other such kind of waves. Automatically, set point two will also be getting right. So which set point is correct? So both the set point is right. Answer both one and two. Simple question. Let us go with respect to our institute question. The same scenario. So what is the question here speaks for instance? Which among the following supercomputer, because the first two question from the UPSC examination, we are connected with the communication technology. The topic is information communication technology. To justify that, let me give you our institute question with respect to the supercomputers, which will have a processing power in the order of estimated processing power of human brain. Okay. The question is too specific that you need to answer for a supercomputer where the supercomputer need to function, it need to perform similar to the human being's brain. It means it need to be a kind of an exaflop supercomputer, 10 to the power 18. Then only a supercomputer can able to have a processing power similar to the human being's brain. So now in that case, among the five, you need to identify which is an exaflop. Frontier, going to be there in USA, it's a kind of an exaflop. Aurora, USA, belongs to an exaflop. Tianhe 3 belongs to the China. It also is a kind of an exaflop. Bull Sequoia, joint development of India and France, 10 petaflops only. Front 2 won't be your answer. Spinnaker, this is an area where you will be committing a mistake. See, if you are reading a current affairs for a prolonged period of time, at least for about some 2019 current affairs, rarely, often you can able to come across this word. Spinnaker is a neuromorphic supercomputer developed by European Union, which can generate artificial brain signals like the human being's brain. And moreover, it is eligible to cure the brain disorders like the Alzheimer's and the Parkinson's disorders can be cured with the help of this Spinnaker. Anyhow, since you came across this word, Spinnaker is a neuromorphic supercomputer. Since that word will be preoccupying in your mind, what you will be committing a mistake means you will be considering Spinnaker will be a kind of a human being's brain related computer. Make it very clear that human being's brain power need to be there, in sense it should be an exaflop. Spinnaker can perform only with the 200 teraflops. Not an answer. This is a trap where you will be falling into this trap. Please be very clear. It's a kind of a teraflop. So it won't function similar to the human being's brain. So now in this case, Frontier, Aurora and the Tianhe 3 will be an answer. So answer will be 3, 4 and the 5. Answer is Delhi. That's it. It's a kind of a simple question but trickier question. If you're being aware about this trick, then definitely you won't commit a mistake. So this is how you need to prepare for the topic called as information communication technology and the robotics. Okay. So next comes the name called as a nuclear technology. In case of a nuclear technology, try to segregate the topic in such a way into two areas. One is the conventional, other is current affairs. One is conventional, other one is the current affairs. In case of a conventional, go with the NCRT. In case of an NCRT, go with respect to the basic terms. Basic terms. Because 50-50 possibilities there with this topic. So NCRT based term in sense, go with respect to, start with the basic itself. So what is nuclear fission? What is nuclear fusion? Fissile material. Fertile material. Isotopes, moderator, coolant, control rods, like that, have a familiarity with respect to the basic terminologies. And here itself, try to know about, among the uranium, you tend to have the different isotopes, which is a natural uranium, which is a artificial uranium, whether uranium is best or thorium is best, try to have a comparison. All these things need to be done under the conversion topic itself. Criticality. One such a kind of word which we come across with the nuclear sense. Basically, criticality in English sense, it gives you the dangerous note. It gives the wrong assumption. Negativity thought will be there when it comes across a word called criticality. But in case of the nuclear technology, criticality means the safest operating conditions of the nuclear power plant is called as a criticality. So now, if you're covering all this kind of a thing, it is called as a conversion. So in case of a current affairs, the second part is a current affairs. In case of a current affairs, try to cover the current affairs part with respect to the recent terms what you came across. So with respect to the Lomoso, academic Lomoso. World's first floating nuclear power plant, which is there in the Russia. It's a current affairs news. Further, Cyclone 30. Cyclone 30. So this is one of the area where we'll be keeping a trap. So Cyclone 30 doesn't speak for any kind of geographical cyclone. Cyclone 30 is the name of the cyclotron facility which got recently launched in the Kolkata. So like that, try to focus with the current affairs. So if you're covering the current affairs, almost I'm about a proton therapy. Proton therapy, doomsday clock, fluorimeter, fluorimeter, periodic table, try to complete it, because periodic table, recently we are completed the 150th year celebration for the current existing periodic table which was given by the Mendeleev. In their case, since 150 years had been completed, we need to have some attention with this periodic table topic also. So once you're done with respect to this current affairs topic, almost some about some 15 to 18 current affairs news is there with the nuclear technology in the recent times. If you're covering with this 15 to 18 current affairs, then nothing will be left out with respect to current affairs part. So 50% probability is there with the conventional and 50% probability is there with respect to the current affairs. If you're covering that, nothing will be left out. Let me give you some examples. What kind of a trend they are following in the previous year, what we are going to face. So with respect to the previous year, comparison is being made with respect to the thorium versus the uranium. Thorium is the most abundant in nature than the uranium. Yes. Thorium can be generated more energy when compared to the natural uranium. Yes. Thorium produces less harmful wastages when compared to the uranium. Yes. All the three is right. Which is right? 1, 2, 3. Where I can able to get this information means NCRT. If you're learning the NCRT, the class 9th and the 10th, which I had recommended for you as an old NCRT, there you can able to find this information. The basic science which is required for the nuclear technology is there in the NCRT itself. Go to the NCRT, you can able to make all the three statements to be getting right. Conceptual question is previous. So this is a kind of a factorator question. So ITR, somewhere else as a matter of reading the current affairs, definitely you need to come across the world class in ITR. ITR is a kind of an international project where India is also participating, where ITR is going to be the kind of a world's first fusion-based reactor. In that case, if you come across the word fusion, then definitely there's an answer. So now, nothing is speaking with respect to fusion. It's a kind of a fusion-based reactor. It's a kind of a factual question. Previous question was a conceptual. Over here, it's a kind of a factual question. So what you can observe with the question number 1 and 2 in sense, current affairs based question is also there. Conventional question is also there. So if you're learning the NCRT, you can able to answer the question number 1. If you're learning the current affairs, you can able to answer the question number 2. So 50-50 possibilities there with respect to nuclear technology. This is a kind of scenario we never seen with respect to IT. We never seen with respect to the defense technology. But here we have this possibility. So don't miss out this possibility. If you're learning such a kind of a NCRT, definitely you can able to answer it. So this is our institute question. The term proton therapy, the current affairs based news, is sometimes seen in the news is related to. So proton therapy is a type of non-radiation. Make it clear. Definitely it can't be non-radiation. It should be a radiation therapy. Since we are speaking with this nuclear technology and second of a therapy, which is used for curing the cancer, of course it should be a radiation therapy. Can be combined with the existing X-ray therapy, chemotherapy and the immunotherapy. That can be right. So definitely as a matter of reading this word non-radiation, statement will be getting wrong. Smaller doses of protons are used to reduce the damage to the healthier tissues. They won't use the smaller doses, heavier doses need to be there. High exit dose doesn't have an exit dose. So if you're sending the proton beam in sense, it stops within your body in sense, it never comes outside. So now, in order to say the second statement is right, now what kind of a caretaking you need to be there in sense, you need to have a clear-cut idea about the term what is proton therapy in the current affairs. Then alone you are supposed to say that among the four statements, which is right, which is wrong. Purely it's a kind of a conceptual understanding. Nothing is a technicality, conceptual understanding. For understanding the concept, definitely can fulfill the statement B is to be the right statement. Right? So this is how the statement will be there for the nuclear technology. The next comes the nanotechnology and the particle science. The nanotechnology and particle science is one such a kind of a Mars scoring topic. Mars scoring topic in your entire science and technology is a Mars scoring topic because the syllabus is well framed and the topic is also very meager amount, very small amount of topic alone is there with respect to the nanotechnology and the particle science. Even you can able to predict also. So first let me say about the particle science, what you need to focus with the particle science. For particle science, go with respect to the particles and its properties present in the NCRT. Okay, what is the particle in sense? nearly about some 10 to 12 particles you can able to find in the NCRT itself. Those particles, whichever is there in the NCRT, that's more than enough. And what kind of information you need to gather from the particle in sense, you need to know about the name of the particles, other name of the particle. For example, Higgs boson is called as a God's particle. You need to know about the other names. Gluon. So gluon is responsible for the binding properties. So like that, each and every particle will have other names. Try to know with the other names and their properties. That's the first line of scenario. Second, know with respect to their abundance. Some will be more abundant. Some will be the least present. Some will be present within the year. Some won't be present in the year. So try to know with respect to the abundance nature. And third comes with respect to the mass. Whether the particle is heavier or lighter. So this much amount of importance is more than enough with respect to the mass. And fourth comes with respect to the word called as charging. The most important point which we need to focus for this topic is charge. Whether it's a positive charge or negative or a neutral. So like that, you need to focus and you need to complete the topic. If you're doing such a way, then that's more than enough with respect to the topic related to the particles and the properties. Need not to search anywhere else. It's already there in the NCRT. Try to utilize this NCRT properly. That's the source. Okay. So next. Next comes the nanotechnology. In case of nanotechnology, what I can recommend in sense, go completely with respect to current affairs. Complete the current affairs. Classic example, you can go with respect to the recent smog tower, which got recently established in the Delhi region to combat the pollution effect. It works based upon the nanotechnology, carbon nanofibers. And here also they can able to frame you some basic information. Try to get the basic clarification. What is carbon fibers, nanotube, nano rod, nano rattles, right? So have this information, have the distinguishing feature among these kind of terms. So beyond that, they won't frame you. Basically, further, you can able to go with the graphene and its properties. So this much amount of basic information is more than sufficient for the nanotechnology, because question anyhow is going to be there only from the current affairs. Okay, they won't question you with the conventional area. Question is anyhow going to be there only from the current affairs. Further, in case of a nanotechnology, for the current affairs, you can able to add one more thing, gold nano rattles, nano pharmaceuticals. So these are some current news, what we nano generators. Which we came across with respect to nanotechnology. So once you've done it, this much amount of, because in case of a nanotechnology or particle science, if any question is going to arise, don't skip that question, because sure shot you can able to make those kind of questions to be getting right. Because since it's a kind of an emerging technology and more or less a kind of a niche technology, they won't frame any such kind of a statement to be getting ambiguity. The statement whichever they are going to frame might be getting possibly to be right only. So this is one of the advantage what you can have with respect to nanotechnology, the particle science. So mostly you can able to find out which statement is right or wrong as a matter of reading first statement or second statement itself, you can come to an answer. So this is one such a kind of a mark scoring topic. Don't skip it. Don't miss it. Try to attend it. Next, have some examples. Look at the question, Higgs boson. UPSC previous year question only, 2013 question. But previously, we got this question only in 2013. After that, we never received a question about the particle science. So it enables us to understand Higgs boson and unable to understand to why the element particle has a mass. Definitely, if you are reading the NCRT, you can say that Higgs boson is a kind of a fundamental particle which unveils how the particle is subject to have a mass. Statement 1 will be the right. Statement 2, it will enable us to, in the near future, to develop the technology to transfer the matter from one point to another point. As a matter of reading the second statement, you can't able to come to a conclusion. It might be, so if you're familiar, you can able to say it. If you're unfamiliar, then definitely it will be troubling you. Okay, stop a while. Second statement, I can't arrive to a conclusion. Let me give a scope for the third statement. It will enable us to create a better fuels for nuclear fission. Fission, heavier element. Heavier element alone can able to support for fission. Fission in sense, the particle need to be there right from the quark. This information is already there in the NCRT. Once again, I am going with the NCRT only. If you are learning the NCRT, you can find that thing. The particle which is starting from the quark can able to support for the fission, above to the quark. Okay. So now in this case, any of Higgs boson can't able to, since it's a fundamental particle, it can't able to support for the fission. To have a nuclear fission, you need to have an element. The particle need to unite together to form an element. So now in this case, to fulfill the nuclear fission, definitely Higgs boson can't able to support it. Sure shot, I can say that statement 3 is wrong. Statement 3 is wrong. Remove 3 in all the given options. B is removed, C is removed, D is removed. Only option to be left out is A. See, easily you can select an option, but what will be a panic condition in sense? As a matter of learning the three statement, you'll be getting tediousness, you'll be getting nervousness. Okay, some amount of tediousness will be there, either you need to attend or not. Don't get tense. Please be cool. You definitely will be having some scope to eliminate some option. Go for option elimination, elimination, elimination technique. Definitely you can find the answer. Even though the second statement is not yet clearly known, as a matter of knowing only one statement, three is wrong, you can be able to find out which statement is right. Next. So next, the second type of a question which we got in the 2015. First question is a conceptual. Second question, here also it's a kind of a slightly conceptual, but practicality, observation. You need not to learn any kind of a thing. Observation matters a lot over here. Nanotechnology, targeted drug delivery system is possible because nanotechnology is focusing only to the particular materials, particular cells. Definitely statement one will be universal right statement. Nanotechnology can largely contribute to the gene therapies. Yes, of course. So now, both the statement will be right. So answer is both 1 and 2. So the second question, what we are seeing is a kind of a simple factual question, slightly tend to have some concepts. So next, go with respect to our institute question, SAA question, regarding the nanopharmaceuticals, the current affairs news. So now, government is going to come out and kind of a committee to frame some guidelines, how to use the nanomaterials for the pharmaceutical sector. Some committee is going to be there. So that's the reason to have this word nanopharmaceuticals to be reported in the newspaper. So now with the nanopharmaceutical, some four statements have been framed. What kind of a mistake you'll be committing at first instance? Now, among the four statement, this is an area where we'll be committing a mistake. Nanopharmaceutical means the pharmaceutical particle size ranges from 1 to 100 nanometer, not 9 nanometers. Nano instance, your mind is fixed with the number 9. No. Here, nanopharmaceutical size ranges from 1 to 100 nanometer. Make this clear. Because these kind of a factual error, you'll be committing it. Please be very clear with respect to these kind of a factual error. Don't run with the preoccupied mindset. Next. Nanomaterials present in the drugs is used for only for external purpose. Whenever you come across this kind of a word, only or basically in sense, it's a kind of a filler word, speed breaker word. You need to stop a word and read the statement once again. So only for external purpose. If you're using only, because nano drugs can be consumed internally, it can be applied externally. Both the purpose you can be able to use it. So now, can we use the external purpose? Definitely statement 2 is B is wrong. Now, nanopharmaceutical guidelines gets classified under the Schedule H category. This as a matter of having the day-to-day activities itself, you can able to find it. If you tend to purchase any tablet strip, you can able to find backside, they'll be mentioning Schedule H. There they'll be printing that this drug comes on a Schedule H, which need to be consumed only with the proper advice of the doctor, and tablet need to be sold only with the proper prescription letter of the doctor. So this is what recommend for the Schedule H. Nanopharmaceutical doesn't come on a Schedule H, it comes on a Schedule Y category. So as a matter of, once again, statement A is connecting to the syllabus only. Application development of science and technology in daily life. So statement A is wrong. So now answer will be statement D only. Now in this case, definitely as a matter of observing the tablet strip on a daily basis, you can say that A is wrong and B is wrong. You are, suppose if you're unfamiliar, you can able to make a guess either with C or D only. And mostly 90% of you will be selecting the statement C, because nanomaterial 9, you had remembered with the number, so it will be making you to commit a mistake. Please be very clear with this factual mistake also, because it's a kind of a trap. So only if you are connecting with the current affairs, then only you can able to connect it. The answer will be the D. So these kind of a question will have a probabilities. But anyhow, if you are struggling to make something to be get as a decent score to clear with the prelims in sense, in that case, no other option to be left out. You need to attend these kind of a question. Suppose if you are in the safest level, safest zone, means don't touch this kind of question, because doubt will be there either with C or D. Definitely A and B is wrong. Doubt will be there either with the C or D. In the doubtful condition, if you are in the safest level, naka, please leave it. If you are struggling, at least one question I need to get right, or two questions I need to get right, naka, rather than touching this kind of a question, you can be able to consider with some other areas. There, at least you can have some scope, because it's a kind of a factual logic. Factual error, if you are strong with the factual, naka, touch with this question. If you're unclear with the fact, naka, don't touch it. It will commit a mistake. Next, biotechnology and the health issues. Okay, so we have completed information communication technology, robotics in the second part, as well as nanotechnology and the particle science, nuclear technology. Three topics we have completed. The fourth topic comes in the name called the biotechnology as well as the health issues. Okay, in case of a biotechnology, as per my words, please stick to with respect to the conventional and the current affairs. For conventional, follow with respect to the 11th and the 12th biology the 12th biology is mandatory. Even if I'm skipping the 11th, leave it. 12th biology is mandatory. And that too already I mentioned with respect to the unit, which you need to study under the 12th biology, that unit is more than enough. So why I'm recommending, in sense, if you're strong with the conventional, then only you can able to understand what they tend to convey you under the current affairs. To make a statement that comes under the current affairs to be right or wrong, you need to have some basic understanding about the biotechnology, where I can get that basic information means, once again, depend with the NCRT. I'm asking you to refer only the source which you tend to have in your hand. Go with the NCRT, you can able to learn about the conventional topic, then fit this conventional topic to the current affairs. This is enough. So this is the way how you need to learn the biotechnology. In case of biotechnology, what are the areas you need to focus in sense? When you come for reproduction, go with respect to the ART techniques. Artificial reproductive technology. Recently, a bill too had been inserted into the parliament. ART techniques. Three-parent child technique. IVF. Surrogacy. Next, come for the cloning. Reproductive cloning, non-reproductive clonings. Next, come for the genome sequencings. Try to have some information about genome sequencing project, like Indigen project of CSIR, National Genomics Grid, Earth Biogenome Project, 100K Asia Genome Project, Human Genome Project, read and write. First stage was a read, now we tend to have stand in the write. So these are the areas which we need to cover under the genome sequencing. Let's go for the gene editing. When you come for a gene editing, two such a kind of a technique which we should not forget to read is that one comes in the name called as a CRISPR-Cas9, which is responsible for trimming as well as joining. Next come for the repair Cas13, it's a kind of a pasting work. So two such a kind of a gene editing technique we need to follow. So gene editing, CRISPR-Cas9, repair Cas13, gene silencing, gene modification, that is a GM. Sterile insect techniques, that's the current affairs news. Population replacement strategy, that is also current affairs news. Hope you might be coming across the word. Insertion of Wolbachia bacteria into the Aedes aegypti mosquito can able to stop the spreading of the dengue and the other mosquito-borne diseases. So in that case, population replacement strategy, Wolbachia bacteria. So these are the things which is highly connected to the topic as a gene. So next, paying attention with respect to some hybrid crops. Hybrid crops. Since you are done with respect to GM crops, parallel try to compete with the hybrid crops also. So recent news with respect to the Ind Masuri crop. So like that, have a glance. So this information is more than enough with respect to genome editings and gene sequencings. Further, you can able to go with respect to the other miscellaneous areas. Like one more thing is there, stem cell therapies. Stem cell therapies. Try to know with respect to types of stem cells. From where these kind of a stem cell is getting extracted. And recent news is there, current affairs news is there, the name called orgonoids. Orgonoids, it's a kind of an artificial stem cell growing conditions. Induced pluripotent stem cell category, we have orgonoids. Go through the orgonoids. Okay. Next, go with respect to the next topic in the name called health and hygiene. Okay. So far, we have spoken about the biotechnology related to the conventional and the current affairs. First, touch with the conventional, then only you can able to understand the current affairs topic. So once you're done with the biotechnology, the next part in this case is the health issues. Okay. In case of health issues, plenty of diseases coming in the newspaper, where I need to stick, which I need to focus. That comes a challenging task over here. Make it clear. Question will be coming mostly with respect to the human being related diseases. Zoonotic disease too also reported in the newspaper. You need not to worry much in detail about the zoonotic diseases. Pay attention with the human being related diseases. Okay. In case of human being related disease also, with respect to the proved diseases where you have the presence of vaccines, where you have the presence of vaccines, or government had taken any kind of an effective measure to combat such a kind of diseases, or time-bound elimination will be there, like our malaria, like our tuberculosis. Time-bound elimination might be there from the government of India. In that case, you need to select these kind of topics, or at least you need to have the mentioning of these kind of diseases in case of the NCRTs. If you turn to find that, then please don't skip in reading it. Please pay attention in reading this kind of a topic with a proved kind of a disease. This is how we used to say a disease to be kind of a proved diseases. And what is not required in sense, not to pay much more importance about the drug which is being used. When you come for time-bound elimination, like the malaria, tuberculosis, try to pay attention with respect to the drug what they are using. for tuberculosis, rifampicin we are using, and pay attention with the drug name, unless until apart from that, we not to worry about the drug names. Forget about the drug names. Okay. So this is how you need to select with the human being related topic. Okay. In case of a diseases, what need to be understand in sense? First focus with respect to the causative agent. Who is the causative agent? Second comes with respect to the symptoms. Third comes with respect to the treatment. Fourth comes with respect to the programs or schemes anyhow which have been launched either by the government of India or with respect to the World Health Organization, pay attention. These information is more than enough with respect to the health-based topic with respect to the human beings. And rarely and rarest they can able to frame a question about the animal-borne diseases. In that case, animal-borne disease will be a factual. Please make it clear. Have a reference with respect to previous year UPSC questions also. You can able to find that animal-based question is coming in sense it will be based upon the factual. Because human being related diseases, if they are framing a question, that will be a common man scenario. Everyone will have an option to write it. But if they are framing any kind of a question related to the animal borne diseases, only a person from the veterinary background can be able to answer it. It will be a kind of a technicality question. So in that case, when it comes for animal based diseases, it will be a factual only. Factual in the sense, you need to know about which causative agent is responsible for spreading these kind of diseases. That's more than enough. So monkey fever, Nipah fever in the sense, try to know about the thing, which is a causative agent. Okay. So once you have done it, go with respect to some current affairs regarding to the programs and schemes can be the current affairs. And you can go with respect to antimicrobial resistance. Antimicrobial resistance. That's an umbrella term which we use to refer for antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral, for everything. We recommend a common word which is called as an antimicrobial resistance. Antimicrobial resistance, you need to cover with respect to Chennai Declaration, Ritalin campaigns. Essential antibiotics. So these are the information which you need to cover under the antibiotics category. The next, go for the personal genomics, gene therapy, salvage therapy. So these information is more than enough and come for the health related issues. Okay. Let me go with respect to some examples about the questions which got arise in the recent times. So 2019 question. With reference to the recent developments in the science, which one among the following statement is not correct? 2019 question only. So, functional chromosomes can be created by joining the segments of DNA taken from the cells of different species. Pieces of artificial DNA, functional DNA can be created by laboratories. Yes, this is right. Piece of DNA taken from the animals. Yes, replicate outside the living cell laboratory. Yes, DNA replication, they are speaking that. Yes, petri dishes, you can able to grow it. Yes, so the incorrect statement is A only. Where I can able to get this statement in sense? Already there in the NCRT. One thing is you need to learn the NCRT. If you learn the NCRT, you can able to get that statement A is wrong. So which is incorrect. It's a kind of a concept-based question. Even though it's a concept-based question, if you're strong with the NCRT learning, definitely you can able to answer these questions. It's not a tough. Once again, it will be a kind of a school-based topic only, because certain kind of an options is there, even below to the 10th standard itself, certain option is there. So option B and option D is already below to the 10th standard level itself, we have these statements. So it's a kind of a conceptual question which we got in 2019. Next, the same 2019, we got question about the health issue, which is none other than the hepatitis. Hepatitis B virus, regarding the hepatitis, which is not correct. So to make it simple, you can go with the B statement, because hepatitis B, unlike hepatitis C, does not have a vaccine. Make it clear, for hepatitis B, comes under the UIP, Universal Immunization Program, we are enlisting the hepatitis B. So in this case, since for curing the hepatitis B, Universal Immunization Program is recommending for the hepatitis B drug is there, then definitely B statement will be the wrong, because they are saying that hepatitis B doesn't have any kind of a vaccine like the hepatitis C. For hepatitis B, we have the vaccine. That's the reason you are including under the UAP program. So B is an incorrect statement. Rest of the other A, C, and D will be the right. So where I can able to get this information means, as a matter of learning the government programs and schemes, you can able to find these word will be there under the UAP. So answer is Bombay. So go with the same pulse with respect to current affairs. Okay. Consider the following statement with respect to organoids. Once it's a kind of a current affairs word. So here, organoids is a kind of an induced pluripotent stem cells. So since the word is pluripotent, try to find whether any pluripotent word is there. No pluripotent. They are saying the totipotent stem cell technique. Definitely statement 3 is wrong. So to find out which statement is right or wrong, what you are using in sense, only one keyword you are using, that it's a kind of a pluripotent. You don't have any pluripotent. Unfortunately, you have the word called as a totipotent. Totipotent means statement 3 is wrong. Remove statement 3. C is removed. You need to find out which is not correct. Not correct in sense, your answer need to have a 3. So not correct statement. It can be a three or it can be none of the above. So here we have a scope for the three. Now go with respect to two. We need to, because three is getting wrong, we need to find out whether two is right or wrong. Organoids had achieved all functional maturity of human organs in the labs. Maturity takes place only within the human beings, not in the labs. Statement two is wrong. Definitely two and three is wrong. Have a cross check with respect to one. It's a group of cells grown in the labs into three-dimensional miniature structure of a fully organ. Yes, one is right. So one speaks for about the statement, what is organoids? See here, in this case, as a matter of finding that pluripotent stem cell, you are finding the totipotent, which is getting mismatched. You are saying that statement three is wrong. Of course, you are coming with the statement, your answer need to have a three. Answer is C only. Even this is a current affairs, you have this option elimination technique strategy in sense, definitely you can able to say, even here, if you're unaware about this organoid also, as a matter of knowing about the maturity of any such a kind of a stem cell can able to take place only within the human being's body. Maturity can't take place. Growth can take place in the lab, but maturity need to be there within the human being's body. So you can say that second statement is wrong. Okay. So this is how you need to deal with the topic related to the biotechnology as well as with the health hygiene. And finally, we are coming with respect to the IPR related topics. Okay. When you come for IPR related topic, what I can say in sense, first, get the information, what are the things that comes under IPR. Then you can able to plan accordingly. So first thing that comes under IPR is, go with respect to the copyright. Copyright. Patent. Second is a patent. Evergreen patent. Evergreen patent. Trademark. Image trademark. Trade secret. Industrial design, geographical indicators, biosimilars, biologics, branded drugs, chemical drugs, which is the generic drugs, branded drugs, generic drugs, PPV and FR, protection of plant varieties and farmers' rights. Okay, this information is more than enough to deal with the question which is related to the IPR. So now, under the IPR, these are the topics which we are enlisted. Now, plan accordingly. So, when it comes for a copyright, try to know about the other name. So, copyright is otherwise called as a regional rights. How many years? The eligibility years. In India, it is given for about 60 years. What are the products that is eligible to get the copyright? Try to have a glance. Whether copyright can be transferred to the other person. Suppose if a person is obtaining a copyright, can he be able to sell the copyright to the other person, or he can be able to share a copyright to the other persons? What are the recent issues that we have came across with the copyright? So these information need to be done for all the subtopics which are enlisted so far for the IPR. If we done it, then this part will be getting over. And in this case, where you can expect a probability of question, since probability of questions will be there with respect to the GI tax. Because GA tax question will be there in the form of a factual, or nowadays, what is the nature they are changing? Since slightly previously, until to the year of 2015 and 16, we got the question only the factual analysis with IPR. But slowly after 2016, the nature of question is moving towards with respect to conceptual. This you can able to witness with the last 2 years of question paper. Conceptual question is coming from the IPR. So please be very clear in learning the conceptual based questions. Okay. So now let me show you some examples regarding the question what we have got in the recent times in 2019. According to Indian Patents Act, biological process to create seeds can be patentable in India. Why to have this question in sense? Due to the last year issue with respect to PepsiCo versus the potato farmers. That's the reason to have this question. So make it clear, we don't have any such a kind of a thing, biological seed to be getting patented in India, that is not available in India. One is wrong. So you need to identify which is correct. So automatically A is removed, D is removed, your answer can be shuttled between B or C. In India, there is no intellectual property appellate board. No. We have intellectual property appellate board. So without that intellectual property appellate board, how you can able to promote it? So definitely, one is wrong as well as two is wrong. So, three. Of course, three need to be there. Plant varieties. Plant varieties are not eligible to be patented in India. Yes, third statement is right. So you can able to find that. If you are saying that one is wrong, automatically you can say that three is right. Because one and three is getting contradicted. So one is wrong, naka, three need to be right. So now, we can able to deliver, and definitely you can say that statement 3 is the right answer. So C is the right answer. Next. So since seed-based question is there, this year you can export some question based upon PPV and FR or International Seed Treaty. So next, we can go with respect to the our initial pre-storming question. So next we can go with respect to our institute, pre-stamming question. So consider the following statement with respect to the GI tax issued in India. So GI tax comes under regional rate. So GI tax doesn't come under regional rate, which is considered as a regional rate means copyright is considered to be the regional rate. So first is wrong. Foreign products can also be taxed. Okay, go with the current affairs itself. In 2019, Irish whiskey had obtained the GI tax in India. Product got originated from Ireland, where they are getting the GI tag, and since they are getting the GI tag in India. So now, statement 2, as a matter of going through the current affairs, you can find it, statement 2 is right. Statement 3, valid for the 10 years from the date of issue. So that even, the statement is right, even if you are unfamiliar, right from the date of issue, 10 years is validated, further renewal is possible. Even if you are unfamiliar with the third statement, go with respect to the option elimination technique, which is not correct. As a matter of learning the current affairs itself, you can able to say that statement 2 is right. If statement 2 is right in sense, you are supposed to ask with the not correct. B can't be your answer, C can't be your answer, D can't be your answer, because 2 statement is right. Only option to be left out is A. See, even if you are unfamiliar with respect to the nature of this statement number 3, still you have an option, still you have a choice to select the right answer. The answer is A, 1 only, which is not correct, 1 only. So, the last part of the strategy analysis process is miscellaneous issue. When you come for miscellaneous issue, so here miscellaneous issue will be anyhow highly connected to the NCRTs. So try to have a touch with respect to NCRT what I had asked. So as a matter of touching with the NCRT, you'll be having an idea to start with respect to miscellaneous. Basically miscellaneous issue will be connected to the current affairs only. Current affairs only. And that too will be in such a way of the term ABC got sometimes seen in the recently seen in the newspaper. Like that, some terms will be there. That's a kind of a miscellaneous area. That miscellaneous area, we can't be able to fit anywhere else with the so far spoken topic. But anyhow, it is connected to the science. Let me give you some example. In 2014, we got this question. Which among the following can be used in the biometric identification process? Iris scanning, retinal, voice recognition. All the three can be used for the biometric identification. So answer goes for D123. So this, we can't be able to fit for anywhere else. Next. With respect to the same scenario, if you're expecting a question, you can go with respect to the kibble balance. So recently, the terminology for the definition for the kilogram got reversed, got changed, where currently, instead of using with respect to any kind of a balancing method, currently the kilogram is being defined with respect to the Planck's constant. So this kind of a word can be fitted to anywhere else with so far spoken topic. This is a kind of a miscellaneous area, but any of the questions related to the science only. So it's a current affairs based topic. So kibble balance will be used to measure the mass of an object. Yes. This is the balance which you are using. Values will be expressed in the Planck's constant. Yes. Second statement is also right. Third, it will change the measurement in our day-to-day life from grocery shop to the industries. Anyhow, your daily life won't have any kind of an change with respect to the change with respect to definition of this kilogram. So it won't affect your day-to-day life. The previously how much amount of sugar you had obtained for 1 kilogram remains to be the same. You won't have any kind of an extra amount of sugar and all. So in that case, it won't affect your daily life. So now, you can able to find the statement number 3, which is connected to our syllabus, application development of science and technology in everyday life. So third statement is connected to the syllabus itself. So as a matter of bringing these changes with the kilogram, it won't affect your day-to-day life activities. So third statement is wrong. So third statement is wrong. You need to identify which among the following statement is right. So 1 and 2 is right. So answer is A, 1 and 2. Third statement is wrong. So you can remove the B, you can remove the C. Answer is A. So this is the way how you need to miscellaneous part. One more example let me give you for the miscellaneous part. Our institute question itself. Which among the following statements, since we are observing with respect to 150th year celebration for the helium, go with respect to the properties of the helium. You need to identify which is correct. Helium is the most, once again, you can't be able to fit this word anywhere else with respect to so far spoken topic. It's a miscellaneous area. Helium is the most common and lightest ever material found in the universe. Which is the lightest? Whether helium or hydrogen? Hydrogen. First is wrong. Lightest nature of helium makes it remain to be the most abundant material in the earth and the sun's atmosphere. In the earth, it's nitrogen. In the sun's atmosphere, it's hydrogen. It gets mostly trapped beneath the surface of the earth in the radioactive rocks of uranium and the thorium. Yes. Earth doesn't have that much amount of helium because earth's gravitational force is that much not sufficient to hold a larger volume of helium into it. But still, we have some trace amount of helium is there that is being stored under the radioactive rocks of uranium and thorium. We have meager amount is there. Fourth statement, helium is unstable. Helium comes under the inert gas group. So if it is an inert gas in sense, it should be kind of a stable. It should not be an unstable. How I can able to get an answer solving technique over here? In sense, once again, I recommend you to go for an NCERT only. Topic is current affairs. Question is current affairs. But answer, you can able to find out as a matter of winning the NCERT itself. So that's more than enough. So here the right answer goes for option C. That's it. So with this, the strategy which is required for your forthcoming prelims is getting completed for the particular science and technology topic. So what I still recommend you in sense, for science and technology based topic, please focus more with respect to the option elimination technique. Option elimination. So far the spoken examples and all the questions what I had narrowed down, you can able to find option elimination will be there. So option elimination matters a lot. Focus more with the option elimination. Next, focus more with respect to current affairs. In case of a current affairs, focus with respect to the proved concept. Don't focus with any case, such a kind of a thing that remain to be an hypothesis. You will be observing the certain universities, certain colleges, ABC colleges, XYZ universities had developed so and so technology. You need not to pay attention to these kind of news and that. If it isn't been proved, or if it had been published as a kind of a news in case of the PAB, naka, pay attention unless until you need not to worry about these kind of a news and that. And finally, please be confident with respect to science and technology based questions, because questions will be simple. No technical trap will be there. Common man trap alone will be there. Don't get afraid. Don't get threatened with respect to the number of statements they are framing. Maximum you can have a 3 statements only. Most probably on an average 3 statements will be there. Where under us 4 options will be there. That also I had explained to you with respect to 4 options. Augmented reality and virtual reality I had explained to you in the previous slides. So in that case, so 4 option statement if it's coming in sense, don't get panicked. Don't get threatened. Definitely the statement will be simple. Science and technology based questions won't have any kind of a technical trap. Technical is not required. It's a common man examination. Only a non-technical analysis is required. Concepts of understanding is required. And that too, a non-technical concept of understanding alone is required. So this information is more than enough. I hope that you can able to crack the examination in the simplest way. All the best for your forthcoming prelim examination. Put your maximum effort and try to come out with a success. All the best. Thank you.